Welcome back. In this chapter, or in this video, we are going to start chapter 3 from the textbook Microwave Engineering by D.M. Ogusar. Chapter 3 is related to the analysis of waveguides and transmission lines. As an introduction, we are going to present the general configurations for different waveguide instructions. At the beginning, we should understand that electromagnetic waves can be transmitted from point A to point B by using two techniques. One technique is by radiating in free space, and in this case, we are talking about transmitting antenna, receiving antenna, and the channel. And the other technique is by using guiding structure. In the guiding structure, the electromagnetic wave is guided through the waveguide structure from the point A to point B, and it is assumed that there is no radiation or there is no power losses in other direction. The simplest configuration for waveguide structure is two-wire transmission lines. Two-wire transmission lines can have many configurations. One of these configurations is coaxial configuration, where there is an outer conductor and an inner conductor. And these two conductors are separated by insulating material or dielectric material. Another configuration is a barrel wire transmission line. In barrel wire transmission line, there are two barrel conductors separated by dielectric material. This transmission line configuration is actually used starting from DC. So we see that such transmission line configuration has no cutoff frequency. Or in other words, the cutoff frequency or the starting frequency of using such transmission lines is F equals 0. And F equals 0, which corresponds to DC. This transmission line is well known for low frequency circuits, and it is also useful for high frequency circuits and microwave circuits. In chapter 2, we have seen that how such transmission line can be represented in terms of distributed element network, where we used the equivalent inductance, resistance, capacitance, and conductance pair lengths. We use such parameters to develop the wave equation of the electric current and electric potential along such transmission line sections. And from this distributed element configuration, we obtain what we call the characteristic impedance of the transmission line. And we have seen that this characteristic impedance of the transmission line depends on the elements of the equivalent distributed network, which actually depends on the field configuration inside the transmission line geometry. Such that we concluded that the parameters of such a distributed element L, C, R, and G depends on the geometry of the transmission line section. Another configuration for waveguide structure is closed waveguide. Closed waveguide is simply hollow pipe from conducting material. From the point of view of conventional transmission lines, it is a transmission line with an outer conductor but without an inner conductor. This is called closed waveguide. Such closed waveguide can be found in the form of rectangular waveguide circular waveguide, elliptical waveguide. So different regular configurations can be used as closed waveguides. Effectively, closed waveguide based on outer conductor can transfer electromagnetic waves from one end to the other end, but it should be have a frequency, or the operating frequency should be greater than what we are calling cutoff frequency. So below the cutoff frequency, such closed waveguide cannot transmit electromagnetic waves. That's why we don't see closed waveguide in low frequency circuits, because in low frequency, the operating frequency is usually below the cutoff frequency, and in this case, the waveguide cannot transfer the power or the electromagnetic power from one point to the other point. However, in microwave range, we can see waveguide which can be used to transfer electromagnetic power from one point to the other point. And in this case, it is quite equivalent to a conventional transmission line. Even so, it doesn't have an inner conductor. Actually, using one conductor as an outer conductor is preferred compared with the coaxial transmission line, because in the conductor, because the conductivity of the conductor is not infinity, we have what we are calling conductor loss. So in the case of a coaxial transmission line, we have a conductor loss for the inner conductor and conductor loss for the outer conductor. But in the case of the closed waveguide, we have only conductor loss for the outer conductor. So closed waveguides are characterized by less conductor loss compared with conventional coaxial transmission lines. On the other hand, as we will see from the field analysis of the coaxial transmission line and the closed waveguide, the concentration of the electric field on the inner conductor is very high, such that it can make breakdown. So the presence of the inner conductor in this case limits the maximum power that can be transmitted through the coaxial transmission line. This is not the situation here, because we don't have an inner conductor here which concentrates the electric field around it. Effectively, closed waveguide was invented as a replacement for coaxial transmission line to be used in high power circuits at high frequency at high frequency bands. So it is mainly used for the systems like radar systems and satellite communication systems, especially in the transmitting case where the power is large and the frequency is large too. On the other hand, for low power, coaxial transmission line, it can be more appropriate, especially if we are looking for dispersion. We will see that closed waveguide has high dispersion compared with coaxial transmission line. All these parameters are going to be studied through the following videos in this chapter. Another configuration for waveguiding structure is strip line structure. Effectively, strip line structure is the configuration of the coaxial transmission line in a planar form, such that the inner conductor is flattened as a strip, while the outer conductor is flattened as an upper and lower ground plane. These two ground planes are separated from the inner conductor by a dielectric material or insulating material. So we can imagine that the strip line configuration is the planar configuration for the coaxial transmission line configuration. And effectively, all the advantages of the coaxial transmission line and disadvantage of coaxial transmission line nearly the same for the strip line. For the case of the strip line or conventional strip line, the dielectric material above the strip and below the strip, which correspond to the inner conductor, are the same. It was decided that what would be the case if the dielectric constant above the strip is different from the dielectric constant below the strip. In this case, the dielectric constant above the strip it can be used as air. The advantage of this configuration is that it can be fabricated as a simple printed circuit board, and after fabricating as a printed circuit board, it is just covered by a grounded plane. So, this is a simple modification from the strip line configuration. Another modification for the covered strip line structure or covered microstrip line structure is that what will be the situation if we removed completely the upper conductor plane. In this case, we have a conducting strip printed on a grounded dielectric slab such that this strip would correspond to the inner conductor of the coaxial transmission line and the ground plane would correspond to the outer conductor of the coaxial transmission line. This is called microstrip line structure. And the advantage of such microstrip line structure is very simple for fabrication. It is very simple for adding components on the same circuit of the transmission line circuit. Unlike the case of closed way or closed waveguides, which are based on hollow pipe of conductor. In hollow pipe of conductors or hollow pipe waveguides, it is very hard to integrate microwave components within the waveguide structure. So in this case, we cut the waveguide structure, convert it to coaxial transmission line, and conduct the component. Here in the case of microstrip line, we can integrate the microwave components directly with the microstrip line. This can be done in the same way as the printed circuit boards. But in the case of microstrip line, this is not completely symmetric transmission line like the case of the strip line or the coaxial transmission line. So in this case, we have a little bit dispersion, which is not the case for the strip line or the coaxial transmission line. Also, the electromagnetic waves in this case is not pure transverse electromagnetic waves, and we will see what it means by transverse electromagnetic waves. Another configuration for waveguiding structure is the slot waveguide. Slot waveguide is composed of two conducting planes separated by slot distance. And these two conducting planes are fixed on a dielectric slab. This dielectric slab, it can be grounded or not grounded. In this case, the electric field is mainly going from one side of the conducting plane to the other side of the conducting plane. And the magnetic field is going in the direction of propagation or along the length of the slot. This is called printed slot line. A similar configuration is called a coplanar waveguide structure. Coplanar waveguide structure can be represented as a planar configuration of coaxial transmission line, where we have an inner conductor surrounded by two ground planes. So these two ground planes correspond to the outer conductor, and this inner conductor correspond to the inner conductor of the coaxial transmission line. And in this case, the electric field is going from the inner conductor to the two sides of the ground plane. Such coplanar waveguide can be grounded such that the slab supporting the coplanar waveguide as a ground plane, or it cannot be used, or can be used without a ground plane too. So there are two different coplanar waveguides, one with a ground plane and one without a ground plane, and each one has its own analysis. Almost all the previous examples are based on conducting structure to transfer the electromagnetic waves. Also, the electric structure can be used to transfer electromagnetic waves. For example, if we have a simple grounded dielectric slab, such a ground dielectric slab can transfer electromagnetic power as a surface wave or at the surface between the dielectric material and air. So, in this case, the field can be transferred through the dielectric slab specifically at the surface of the slab or the air slab interface, and is used as a dielectric waveguide. Effectively, any grounded dielectric slab supports what we are calling transverse magnetic mode, and the cutoff frequency of the dominant TM mode in grounded dielectric slab is zero. So at any frequency, a grounded dielectric slab can support the dominant transverse magnetic mode of the surface waves. That's why in microstrip configuration, where we have a conducting plane above the dielectric slab or at the interface between the air and the dielectric slab, such conducting plane or such conducting plate will support a transfer of electromagnetic power through the microstrip line configuration. In addition, we have some hysteresis or some power transferred on the slab as surface waves, and these surface waves has significant contribution in the mutual coupling between transmission lines. Also, it has significant contribution between the mutual coupling between microstrip antennas, as we will study in microstrip antenna in the future. Another configuration for dielectric waveguide is a grounded slab dielectric and loaded by a dielectric rod. In this case, the electromagnetic waves is mainly concentrated in the dielectric rod and is transferred from one point to the other point through the upper dielectric rod. A circular configuration of this planar configuration is known as optical fiber, and effectively optical fiber has a very important role in optical communication systems. Optical fiber is a dielectric waveguide structure. It is composed of a dielectric core with high dielectric constant or high reflective index N1, surrounded by a cladding material. This cladding material is another dielectric material with slightly less dielectric constant. In this case, the electromagnetic wave is mainly concentrated inside the core and is transferred from the beginning to the end of the optical fiber inside the core. This optical fiber actually the basic of optical communications. In the present course, we are going only to study the surface waves on the ground dielectric slab. However, the theory of the surface wave of ground dielectric slab represents the basic theory for studying other dielectric waveguide configurations like dielectric rod and optical fibers. In the following video, we are going to formulate Maxwell's equation for the case of guiding structure, and from this formulation, we are going to solve the Maxwell equation for guiding structure for different configurations of guiding structures like barrel blade waveguide, rectangular waveguide, circular waveguide, grounded dielectric slab, microstrip line, and other configurations. Okay? All right.